Major funding for this afternoon's programming is provided by the Helena Rubinstein Foundation, a longtime supporter of outstanding children's television.
Today's taper is presented by WQED Pittsburgh and WGBH Boston. Carmen's gang is bankrolled by the Corporation for Public Broadcasting and viewers like you.
This program is brought to you by Toyota.
All these people want to know, where in the world is Carmen Sandiego? And one of these people could find her. Matthew Gruber. Nancy Ross. Anmy. Today's episode, Who Stole the Bowl? And this is special agent in charge of training new recruits, Greg Lee.
Hi, how are you guys?
Okay.
Ready to go to work?
Yeah.
All right, let's get the chief on this thing here. Chief, you there?
I'm here, Greg. You got me?
Yes, ma'am.
All right. Detective, Carmen's pack of degenerate jackals has struck again. This time, they burgled the Hollywood Bowl in California, the world-renowned outdoor amphitheater. Now, yesterday evening, Double Trouble crashed a concert and danced onto the stage before a stunned audience. Then they picked up the bowl and carried it into the hills, leaving a hole where the bowl once stood. Now, here's the dirt on Double Trouble. They only take two things seriously, partying and pilferage. Your mission, dispossess Double Trouble. Bring back the bowl, then capture Carmen Sandiego. Greg!
Thanks, Chief. All right, gun season, we're going to start you off with 50 Acme crime bucks. Anytime you're right, we'll give you an additional 10 crime bucks. And the two of you that have the highest scores at the end of this round will then proceed to the next round. All right? Okay, Chief, let's get started.
All right, Gumshoe, here's what we know. Double Trouble are planning to use the bowl for a huge reggae concert in a West Indies nation. Now, Rastafarian culture began there in the 1930s. Its followers worshipped an Ethiopian emperor named Rastafari. But you may have heard of him by a different name, Haile Selassie. Greg?
All right, Gumshoe's named the country. Is it Jamaica, Belize, or Bahamas? Remember the clues that we heard? Reggae concert, West Indies nation, Rastafarian culture. Everybody's ready. Matthew, we'll start with you. What do you say?
Jamaica.
What do you think, Nancy?
Bahamas.
How about you, Anmy?
Jamaica.
Jamaica. The answer we're looking for is Jamaica. Nice job, Matthew and Anmy. Nice way to start it off. Matthew, you have 60. Nancy, 50. Anmy, 60 for you. Now, before we get too far into this, let's find out a little bit about you, detective, shall we? Matthew, you had an adventure in Canada, right?
Yes.
Tell us about it.
Well, I was on Niagara Falls, and we were looking at it. My uncle was pretending to drop me, and then one time he actually did, and I almost fell down.
Oh, that's great. Fun with uncle. Good, good. Okay, Nancy, what do you like to do in your spare time?
I like to paint and to count my buttons that I have.
Mm-hmm. And what do you like to paint?
Scenes, nature.
Very nice. Okay. Anmy? That's a very pretty, unusual name. Where does it come from?
It comes from Vietnam.
Really? And you have your mother's from Vietnam?
Yeah. My father's from Switzerland.
Great. Okay. Listen, it's great to have you all in the case. Good luck. Relax. Have a good time. Let's get started. Okay. Our second clue comes to us. We've called in a special Acme CelebNet agent that's going to help us with this, Dan Lauria. Dan?
Listen up, Gumshoes. I got the scoop. Actually, it's more like a snow shovel. Double Trouble are headed up to a great ski party in the Colorado Rockies. It's in a town on the Roaring Fork River that's named after a tree. Double Trouble are probably off autograph hunting because Don Henley, Jack Nicholson, and Goldie Hawn all live there. Hey, how come Double Trouble never asked for my autograph?
All right, thanks, Dan. Gumshoes, name the town. Is it Jackson, Vail, or Aspen? Remember the clues that we heard from Dan? Colorado Rockies, Roaring Fork River, and named after a tree. Come up with an answer as quick as you can. Nancy's ready. Anmy's ready. Matthew, you're ready. Let's hear from you first, Matthew. What do you say?
Aspen.
Aspen. What do you think, Nancy?
Aspen.
Aspen. How about you, Anmy?
Aspen.
Everybody says Aspen. Everybody's right. Nice job, Gumshoes. Okay. So, Matthew, you have 70. Nancy, you have 60. Anmy, you have 70. So that means they're still pretty close. No, that's the unmistakable sound of general hubbub. Come on, let's check the word on the street. Hey, fellas.
Hey, man.
What's the word on the street?
Hey, man, the word on the street is zydeco. That means dancing music in a southern state. Crank it up, Barry.
Rock it up.
Nice.
Yeah, them Double Trouble Boys, they went down to the Mudbug Madness Crawfish Celebration down in Shreveport. Sounds great, huh? I sure wouldn't miss it.
Whew. Okay, hey, listen. Zydeco. All right, Gumshoes, name the state. Is it Louisiana, Mississippi, or Tennessee? Remember the clues that we heard from the word on the street? Zydeco, crawfish, and Shreveport. Everybody's ready. Anmy, you ready?
Yeah.
Okay, Matthew, we'll start with you. What do you say?
Louisiana.
Louisiana. Nancy?
Louisiana.
Louisiana. Anmy?
Tennessee.
Tennessee. The answer we're looking for is Louisiana. Nice job, Matthew and Nancy. So that means, Matthew, you have 80. Nancy, you have 70. Anmy, you have 70. Still very close, guys. That's the way to play this thing. Keep it nice. It only means one thing. It's time for the lightning round. We're going to give you a chance now to get some extra crime bucks. So hands on buzzers, please. I have three questions here. Any one of you that answers any one of these correctly, I'll give you an extra 5 crime bucks, okay? Listen very closely. Here we go. In a deal signed between Thomas Jefferson and Napoleon in 1803, the U.S. not only got Louisiana, but territory that doubled the young country's size. Name this famous treaty. Nancy.
Treaty of Paris?
I'm sorry, that's not the answer we're looking for. Matthew?
Louisiana Purchase.
Louisiana Purchase. Nice job. Okay. Brings up 5 more. Matthew to 85. Question 2. Listen. Driven from their home by the British, the Acadians left eastern Canada in the 1750s, eventually settling in Louisiana. Are their descendants Creole, Anglo-Saxon, or Cajun? Nancy.
Anglo-Saxon.
Sorry, that's not the answer we're looking for. Matthew?
Cajun.
Cajun's what we're looking for. Good, yeah. Yeah, Cajun is a mispronunciation of the word Acadian, which I know a little something about, all right? Question number 3. You're eating a spicy bowl of gumbo during the Mardi Gras celebration in New Orleans. Are you enjoying soup, cereal, or salad? Nancy.
Soup.
Soup is right. There you got it. Okay. So that means, at the end of 3, Matthew, you have 90, Nancy, you have 75, Anmy, you have 70. Still very close.
Now. Greg!
Yes,
Greg, get in my office right away.
Oh, yes, all right, okay. I'm going to go check with her. You guys stick around here. It's time for me to go have a little chat with the chief. Yes, what's up?
Greg, have you seen the headlines this week?
No.
Acme crime net going nowhere,
no.
Sam?
Oh, no, no,
We are the laughingstock of the entire law enforcement community.
No.
Gumshoes. You have got to get Carmen Sandiego. Now, if you do, I will give you a free trip anywhere in the lower 48 states.
Hey. Nice going, Chief. I mean, that's a good move on your part, because we really can't afford any bad PR right now. Once you get bad PR, you're down the tubes from there.
Go away.
All right, Gumshoes, a lot of work to do still. Remember, we're after Double Trouble trying to find the Hollywood Bowl. Fortunately, Acme Bugnet has just given us this information. They come up with a phone conversation between Double Trouble and Carmen Sandiego. Listen.
Bad news, boys. Acme is on to you. Cancel your shows and take the bowl on the road.
Hey, just point us to a party, Carmen, and we're on our way.
Then head for Carnival in the South American town of Oruro. It's an 8-day party in the Altiplano. That's the High Plains region of a landlocked country.
Geez, an 8-day party? Sounds pretty intense.
Oh, it is. Especially La Diablada, the Devil Dance. It's a wild parade through the streets in costumes that lasts a full day.
A Devil Dance, Carmen? Hey, that's our kind of town.
Okay, Gumshoes, name the South American country. Is it Paraguay, Bolivia, Ecuador? Remember the clues that we heard? Carnival in Oruro, Antiplano, and landlocked country. Everybody's ready. Matthew, we'll start with you. What do you say?
Bolivia.
Bolivia. What do you think, Nancy?
Ecuador.
Ecuador. What do you think, Anmy?
Ecuador.
Ecuador. The answer we're looking for is Bolivia. Nice job, Matthew. Okay, so Matthew, you have 100, Nanci 75, Anmy 70, starting to pull up. Wait a second. Something's going on out here. Let's go out here and check, see what it is. But I have one question. How can that song help us find double trouble?
Well, that song is from the Yoruba people. And it says that it's important to treat children with respect because within the children are the spirits of their ancestors. Now, those crooks are in an African country where the Yoruba live. Search Lagos on the Gulf of Guinea.
Okay. Thanks, lady. Mm-hmm. All right, Gumshoes. Name the African country. Is it Nigeria, Guinea-Bissau, Gabon? Remember the clues that we've heard? Yoruba people, Lagos, and Gulf of Guinea. Everybody's ready? Matthew, we'll start with you. What do you say?
Nigeria.
Nigeria. Nanci, what do you think?
Nigeria.
Anmy, how about you?
Nigeria.
Nigeria. The answer we're looking for is Nigeria. Nice job. So Matthew has 110, Nanci has 85, Anmy has 80. Now, for our next clue, we turn now to an agent of Acme Fishnet. Watch.
Oh, sure, Greg. Last night you had oysters on the half shell, and today you want pearls of wisdom. You ate my great-uncle Max. Come on. Well, I've had it. This is my last clue. My sturgeon friends called me from the Caspian Sea. Ugh, what goes on with the caviar there? It breaks my heart. I mean, who could care about a big balalaika concert in Baku? I just don't understand humans. Get into therapy and leave us shellfish alone, okay?
Okay, Gumshoes, name the Soviet Republic. Is it Azerbaijan, Georgia, or Turkey? Remember the clues that we heard? The Caspian Sea, Balalaika, and Baku. Everybody's ready? Matthew, we'll start with you. What do you say?
Azerbaijan.
Nanci?
Georgia.
On me?
Azerbaijan.
The answer we're looking for is Azerbaijan. Nice job. Okay, Matthew has 120, Nanci has 85, Anmy has 90. High scoring game right now, but I need to tell you, this is the final clue of this round, which means it's time for you to make a decision. It's time now for you to decide how much you want to risk. If you're right, we'll add that amount to your score. If you're not correct, we'll subtract it from your score. You can risk 0, 10, 20, 30, 40, or 50 Acme Crime Bucks, all right? Take a look right over here, if you will, please. Here's a portion of the world where we think double trouble is headed. If you know a lot about this part of the world, you may want to risk a lot. If you don't know very much about it, you may not want to risk quite so much, okay? So take a look at the map and think about it. Okay, everybody's made a decision. Nice job. For the last clue, let's check the file, see if we can come up with something. Oh, hey, it's a CD. Maybe this thing here will give us the information we're needing. Let's just put this over here and see what we come up with.
Knock off that racket!
So upstairs neighbor, Mrs. Pumpkin Clan. Be right back.
This is so tiresome! Must I always paint you a picture? You were listening to Gagaku. That means elegant music. It's from Japan. And that's where you'll find double trouble, in the town of the two most sacred shrines of the Shinto religion. Check the Shima Peninsula on Honshu Island. Now don't just stand there. Get on with it.
Thanks, Mr. Pumpkin Clanger. All right, Gumshoes, name the Japanese town. Is it Maroto, Suzu, or Issei? Some of the clues that we heard, sacred shrines of Shinto religion, Shima Peninsula, and Honshu Island. Okay, we're going to start with Nanci. You have 85 crime bucks. Before you show me your answer, how much did you risk?
20 crime bucks.
You risked 20 crime bucks. This will put you right back into the game again if you're right. What'd you say?
Maroto.
Oh, sorry, that's not the answer we're looking for. Tough break there. Anmy, you have 90. How much did you risk?
I risked 0.
You risked 0, okay. Put it right on up there. That means whether you're right or wrong, you'll stay at 90. What'd you say?
Suzu.
Oh, Suzu. Sorry, that's not the answer we're looking for either. But you'll stay at 90. You're still in second place. Matthew, you're in the lead right now with 120. How much did you risk?
10 crime bucks.
10. That means if you're wrong, you'll just go down to 110, and you and Anmy will go into the next round. If you're right, the same thing will happen. What'd you say? It's Suzu. That's not the answer we're looking for. We're looking for Issei. Right. But anyway, Matthew and Anmy, you're going on to the next round anyway. Congratulations. Good job. Nanci, you're a great detective. Sorry things didn't work out for you. But we've put together a kit that's going to help you in the next case. Chief?
It's the official Acme Crime Net travel kit, and it includes a World Traveler's Atlas, the official Carmen watch, a Carmen sweatshirt, and a subscription to National Geographic World Magazine. And thanks for all your good work on this case, Nanci. I salute you.
Thanks, Chief. Okay, guys, now it's time for you to go to Issei to try to track down Double Trouble and find the Hollywood Bowl. You got to catch them and bring it back, okay? But I want you to know we don't send our agents out into the field unprepared. Chief, how about a briefing?
Now, here's the scoop on Japan. Located off the coast of East Asia, population 125 million. Major religions, Buddhism and Shintoism. Now, the boys down at Photo Recon have put together a few slides for you. Now, of Japan's 80,000 Shinto shrines, the two at Issei are the most important. Every 20 years, they're torn down, and identical new ones are built using ancient construction methods. Next, Nijojo Castle, Kyoto, built in 1603. Now, mechanisms in the floor chirp when people walk over them. This was meant to detect assassins, so listen for double trouble. Tokyo, Japan's capital, founded in the 12th century as Edo. At 12 million people, it's one of the most populous cities on Earth. Question everyone. Now, here are some Acme Japan Net agents climbing Mount Fuji. Now, like many people, they've begun in the middle of the night so that they can see the sunrise from the top of the mountain. And the crater at the top of the mountain is a good place to look for the Hollywood Bowl. Mount Fuji is a dormant volcano, and its last major eruption was in 1707. Now, Gumshoes, that's Japan. You're headed out into the field now, so always remember the Acme Triangle of Excellence. Vigilance, dedication, courage. Begin the Crime Net countdown. Five are the senses you need. Four, putting crooks on the run. Three rounds to fight against greed. To be sure, justice is won. Go get them, Gumshoes.
Hey, Gumshoes, here we are in Japan. Put your stuff down right there. Take a walk right over there, and let me show you what we've got here. Here are the locations where you might find Double Trouble, the Hollywood Bowl, and a warrant for Double Trouble's arrest. Now, the first thing you have to do is find the loot. That's the evidence you need so that you can get a warrant. Once you get the warrant, then you can arrest the crook. If you connect all three of those, the loot, the warrant, the crook, in a single turn, in that order, then you get a chance to try to catch Carmen Sandiego. Catch Carmen Sandiego, and you get that trip to anywhere in the lower 48 United States. Now, one more thing. You can pick any location you want to, but if you happen upon the loot, the warrant, or the crook, you get a free look, okay? Matthew, you are ahead of the end of the last round. You go first.
Okay, Mount Fuji.
Mount Fuji.
The Gold Pavilion. And
the Hollywood Bowl.
The Hollywood Bowl. Now you get a free look. Go ahead.
Okay, Kyoto Station.
Which one? Kyoto Station, okay. Kyoto Station, okay.
Mount Fuji.
Mount Fuji.
The Hollywood Bowl.
There it is. Go ahead.
Imperial Place.
Imperial Palace.
Palace.
Nothing there. Okay, Matthew, your turn.
Mount Fuji.
Mount Fuji.
Nice
camera.
Action.
Lake Psycho.
What is it? Lake Psycho.
Double trouble.
Okay, you got two there, but remember, you have to keep in the right order, the loot, the warrant, and the crook, so use some strategy here.
Zen Garden.
Zen Garden. Nothing there, okay? On me, your turn.
Mount Fuji.
Mount Fuji.
Like camera.
Cut. Downtown Tokyo.
Downtown Tokyo. Nothing there. Okay, we found two of them. Looking for the last one. Go ahead,
Mount
Matthew.
Mount Fuji.
Mount Fuji.
Once again, the Hollywood Bowl.
Great Buddha Hall.
Great Buddha Hall. Nothing there. Okay, Anmy, your turn.
Mount Fuji.
Yes, Mount Fuji.
Alas, the Hollywood Bowl.
Your turn, Anmy.
Zen Garden.
Zen Garden. Nope, nothing there. Looking for that
Mount
one
Fuji.
More. Matthew, go ahead.
Mount Fuji.
Mount Fuji.
The darn bowl already.
Go ahead, Matthew.
Sandman Gate.
Sandman Gate. Nothing there. Go ahead, Anmy. I wonder what your first choice will be.
Mount Fuji.
Yes.
The Hollywood Bowl.
Go ahead, Anmy.
Nijo Castle.
Nijo Castle. Nijojo Castle. Nothing there.
Okay,
okay.
Fuji.
Matthew. Mount Fuji.
Shinto Shrine.
Wait 1 second, Matthew. Now go.
Shinto Shrine.
Shinto Shrine. Nothing there. Go ahead, Anmy.
Mount Fuji.
Yes, Mount Fuji.
The bowl.
Now on.
Ginza District.
Ginza District. Yeah, we tried that one once before. Okay, Matthew, go ahead.
Mount Fuji.
Mount Fuji.
The bowl.
Go ahead, Matthew.
Okay. Great Buddha Hall.
Looking for that warrant. Is it there at the Great Buddha Hall? Nope, we tried that before. Go ahead, Anmy.
Mount Fuji.
Mount Fuji.
The bowl.
Gold Pavilion.
Gold Pavilion. Is it there?
The Warren.
That's two. You need one more. Do you remember where it is?
Lake Psycho.
Lake Psycho? Yeah. That's the way. That's the way. Come on over here, Anmy. Nice job. Okay, so you got double trouble. There's one more thing you need to do. Pull on this and put him in jail.
A double trouble. Double.
Congratulations. Listen, we're going to talk about your next adventure in just a little bit. Matthew, listen, you're a great detective. You did some great stuff. We have some great stuff for you. Chief?
It's a pocket translator for instant translations of 14,000 words and phrases in 10 European languages. Nice work, Matthew.
Okay, got a little paperwork for you to do here. Open this up for you. We've got some paper in there and a marker. I want you to write down where you will go if you catch Carmen Sandiego. Write it nice and big.
Where do you want to go?
We're going to keep this top secret now. And we'll find out if you get this or not. You've had a good day, right? You got double trouble. You also got the loot, the Hollywood Bowl. And now, hold on 1 second. Hold on to this for me, please. Look at this. Hello? Yeah, she's right here. Hold on. See you.
Hello?
We'll party a lot hardier in the slammer if we know Carmen's on her way. Look for her in Asia.
Well, it looks like you and I are going to Asia. Chief?
Okay. Anmy, here's a list of places Carmen may have traveled. Jordan. Iran. Qatar. Afghanistan. India. Sri Lanka. China. Bangladesh. Myanmar, Indonesia, South Korea, the Philippines, Japan. Greg, take Anmy to the mat.
Okay, Anmy, this is what it's all about right now, okay? It's time now for you to track Carmen Sandiego through seven different countries, identifying each country with a marker. If you're right, you'll hear this sound. But if you're wrong, you'll hear this sound. I don't want to hear that too many times. If you hear it twice, then just leave the marker where it is. We'll go on to the next one. If you're right, though, seven times in 45 seconds, you're going to win that trip to wherever you wrote in that portfolio. Sound good to you?
Yep.
Sound good to you guys? Okay. I want to show you something. This particular continent is a lot wider than some of the other ones, so I want to show you just exactly where you're at. Over there's the Mideast. Here's Central Asia. Over there's Southeast Asia. And off to your left is the Pacific Ocean. Okay? Let's get started. Cheer on, folks. Here we go. Okay, let's get 45 seconds up on the clock. Good luck, Anmy. Here we go. On your mark, get set, go. Carmen went to Qatar. No, that's not it. Try it again. Is that it? Come on, let's try it. Come on. Leave that there. Come on. You can come. Come, come, come. Carmen went to Afghanistan. Afghanistan. Nope, try it again. Try it again. That's not it. Come on, come on, come on. Carmen went to Indonesia. Indonesia. You can do it. You can do it. Come on. Indonesia. Nope. Try it again. Try it again. Nope. Come on. Carmen went to Bangladesh. 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 No, try it again. Try it again. Bangladesh. Oh, no. Oh, shoot. Oh, come on. Let's hear it for her anyway, folks. Come here. Tough break, pal. I'll tell you. Sometimes Carmen Sandiego is just pretty tough to catch. That's all it is. But remember, you did get double trouble, and you got all that loose. So you did good work. What do you think, Chief?
We're all proud of the good work you did, Anmy, throughout the day. And we here at headquarters, well, we pitched in and purchased a portable CD player we thought you might enjoy, and a selection of CDs from around the world.
That's not bad, right? All right. Listen, you've been working for us pretty hard today. I know that. There's one more thing I want you to do. You know what it is. Do it, Rock Up.